Welcome to Sai Jain Academy. In continuation of Industrial Automation, Part 5, Thyristor Turn-On Method. With the anode is positive with respect to cathode, a thyristor can turn on by any one of the following techniques, that is, forward voltage triggering, gate triggering, dV by dt triggering, temperature triggering, and light triggering. Here, the battery or supply voltage positive is connected to anode. Negative terminal of the supply voltage is connected to cathode or N region, N layer, that is what we call as cathode, keeping gate open. We use forward voltage triggering. As you discussed earlier, forward voltage triggering. So, forward voltage triggering, J1, J3 is forward bias, J2 is reverse bias, depletion region is formed across J1. So when we make this, when we connected the positive terminal of anode to anode P layer and negative terminal to cathode N layer, J1 and J3 is forward biased, only J2 is reverse biased. This J2 forms the depletion region. Got it? Width of the depletion region decreases with increase in anode cathode voltage. By increasing the anode cathode voltage, we can decrease the depletion layer, which is J2. If forward voltage across anode cathode is gradually increased, a stage comes when depletion layer across J2 vanishes. If you go on rising, gradually you increase the voltage across this SCR or anode cathode terminal, the stage comes at which the depletion layer J2 vanishes, means completely it is allow the current to flow from anode to cathode. At this moment, reverse bias junction J2 is said to be avalanche breakdown. This question may ask in a objective questions or in our CT questions. And voltage at which it occurs is called forward breakover voltage, we discussed earlier. From IV characteristics, breakover voltage and shifts to its on state position with breakover current IBO. So here, you can see here, this voltage, the VBO voltage we are increasing in x-axis, in y-axis we are getting the current. So slowly gradually we are increasing the voltage till VBO. Once it reaches to the VBO, all of a sudden it will shift this position from M to N. Further, it allows the current to flow. Okay, that current is IBO. At this voltage, thyristor changes from off state to on state. J1, J3 are already forward biased. Breakdown of junction J2 allow free movement of carrier across the three junctions. And as a result, a large forward anode current flows. Large forward anode current flow. So this is the blue color what we have shown is the large anode current flows through the all the junction. This forward current is limited by load impedance. We discussed earlier, once it enters into the conduction mode, further it doesn't come back to off state. It is in conduction mode. The voltage what we obtain after switching from off state to on state is very small voltage. Small voltage. This is the small voltage from here to here. This is the small voltage. Once it switches from off state to on state, this is the voltage here. So this voltage is 1 or 2 volts after it is switching from off state to on state. Next one is gate triggering. Turning on of thyristor by gate triggering is simple, reliable and efficient. ಯಾಕೆ ಗೇಟ್ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಗೇಟ್ ಟ್ರಿಗರಿಂಗ್ ಬೇಕಾಗುತ್ತೆ? ಯೂಶ್ವಲಿ ಯಾವ್ದಾದ್ರು ಎಸ್ ಸಿ ಆರ್ ಅನ್ನ ನಾವು ತಗೊಂಡಾಗ ಎಸ್ ಸಿ ಆರ್ ಅದರ ರೇಟಿಂಗ್ ನಾವು ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀವಿ. ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್, ನಾನು ಒಂದು 800 volts ಇರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಎಸ್ ಸಿ ಆರ್ ಅನ್ನ ತಗೊಂತ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ. ನಾರ್ಮಲಿ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಒಪ್ಟೈನ್ ಈವನ್ 230 volts ಆರ್ 440 volts ಇನ್ at a laboratory. It is not enough to trigger the SCR. ಅದು ಸಾಕಾಗಲ್ಲ. 800 volts ವಿ ಬಿ ಓ ಬೇಕು. ಆದರೆ ಅಷ್ಟು ವಿ ಬಿ ಓ 800 volts ವಿ ಬಿ ಓ ನಮಗೆ ಈವನ್ ತ್ರೀ ಫೇಸ್ ಸರ್ಕ್ಯೂಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಕೂಡ ನಮಗೆ 440 volts ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ, ಅದಕ್ಕಿಂತ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಸಿಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ಇನ್ ಲ್ಯಾಬೊರೇಟರಿ ಸಿಚುವೇಶನ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ವಿ ಬಿ ಓ ದ ಹ್ಯೂಜ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ VBO, we cannot get from here to here. The VBO, it may be 600 or 800 depending upon the specification of your SCR, what we discussed earlier. This VBO is a huge voltage we require. It is not we get in the laboratory. That's why for the efficient and simple and reliable triggering technique is gate trigger. Say we are applying the forward voltage, that is the battery. The positive of power supply given to the anode, negative of the power supply is given to the cathode, and the gate and cathode is connected by another supply voltage, that is VGC. It provides the gate voltage across the gate and cathode. This provides the gate current. It provides the gate current to the P region. When you please understand, this is a N-type material which is there in the cathode. It is heavily doped compared to the P region, which is lightly doped. So it is heavily doped means it flooded with heavy electrons to this N region, and the positive potential it is given to this. As some, what happened is some of electrons after recombination everything, some of the electrons is moving from, jump from N region to P region, and it vanishes this J2 junction. Our aim is to vanish this J2 junction, then only the conduction takes place and anode to cathode current flows. So what we have to do, say for example 800 volts we require, 800 volts, that is VBO is 800 volts, assume it. ಈಗ ನಮ್ಗೆ 800 volts ಬೇಕು VBOಗೆ without connecting to this VGC, that is gate cathode voltage. So ನಾನು ಗೇಟ್ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಅನ್ನ ನಿಧಾನವಾಗಿ ವೇರಿ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಹೋಗ್ತಿದ್ದೇನೆ. gate current across this gate and cathode voltage VGC nanu nidanagi vary martta hogta idine adrinda a small current flows through the gate terminal. So here IG is equal to 0 iddaga nanage VBO voltage bekagittu iga nanu shift martta idine 800 volts assume it is 800 volts nanu en martini iga I provide V1 voltage from VGC. It's a around say 1 volts we take it as 1 volts kortta idini. Now apply voltage within a 30 volts regionally 30 volts DC irbodu. Assume I am saying that assume it. ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀನಿ ಗೇಟ್ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಅನ್ನ ನನಗೆ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಡ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಏನ್ ಬೇಕಾಗಿದೆ ಅದು ಬಿಬಿಓಕ್ಕಿಂತ ಕಡಿಮೆ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಬೇಕಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಯಾವುದು ಈ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಫಾರ್ವರ್ಡ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಅಂತ ಏನ್ ಪವರ್ ಸಪ್ಲೈ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ನಮಗೆ ಕಂಪೇರ್ ಟು ಬಿಬಿಓ ಕಡಿಮೆ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಬೇಕು ಸೇ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ನಾನು 1 ವೋಲ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಕೊಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ ನನಗೆ ಬೇಕಾಗಿರೋ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜು ನಾನು ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಇಷ್ಟು ಬೇಕು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನನಗೆ ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ 130 ವೋಲ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಅಸ್ಯೂಮ್ ಈ 30 ವೋಲ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ವರ್ಡ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ 1 ವೋಲ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಕೂಡ ಸಪ್ಲೈ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ ವಿಜಿಸಿ ಅಕ್ರಾಸ್ ವಿಜಿಸಿ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಅಪ್ಲೈಯಿಂಗ್ 1 ವೋಲ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಅದೇ ತರ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸಿಂಗ್ ದಿ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ I am increasing the gate cathode voltage, then I require VB voltage is V2. ಅದೇ ತರ ನಾನು ಏನಾಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನನಗೆ 800 ವೋಲ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಬೇಕಾಗಿತ್ತು V1 ಅಪ್ಲೈ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ನನಗೊಂದು 300 ವೋಲ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಬೇಕಾಗತ್ತೆ V2 ಅಪ್ಲೈ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ನನಗೆ ಒಂದು ಸುಮಾರು 100 ವೋಲ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಬೇಕಾಗತ್ತೆ ನಾನು ಬೈ ಚಾನ್ಸ್ V3 ಅಪ್ಲೈ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ V3 ಗೇಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾಥೋಡ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಅನ್ನು ಅಪ್ಲೈ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ V3 ನನಗೊಂದು 30 ವೋಲ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಒಳಗೆ ಈ ಒಂದು SCR ಟ್ರಿಗರ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ಗೇಟ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ V1 V2 V3 ಆರ್ ಗೇಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾಥೋಡ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಸೊ ಟ್ರಿಗರಿಂಗ್ ನನಗೆ ಬೇಕಾಗಿರೋ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜು VBO ಇತ್ತು 800 ವೋಲ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಇತ್ತು ಅದಕ್ಕಿಂತ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಆಯಿತು ಮತ್ತೆ V2 ಅಪ್ಲೈ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ಅದಕ್ಕಿಂತನೂ ಕಡಿಮೆ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಆಯಿತು ಈಗ V3 ಅಪ್ಲೈ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀನಿ ಸೇ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ 5-6 ವೋಲ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆವಾಗ ನನಗೆ ಬೇಕಾಗಿರೋ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ವಿತಿನ್ 30 ವೋಲ್ಟ್ಸ್ ರೇಂಜಲ್ಲಿ ಈ SCR ಅನ್ನ ನಾನು ಟ್ರಿಗರ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ ಟ್ರಿಗರ್ ಮಾಡೋದು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಏನು ದ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಫ್ಲೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಆನೋಡ್ ಟು ಕ್ಯಾಥೋಡ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಎ ಒನ್ ಯೂನಿ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಷನಲ್ ಡಿವೈಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಎ ಸ್ವಿಚಿಂಗ್ ಡಿವೈಸ್ Say, when turn on of thyristor requires a positive gate voltage between gate and cathode is applied. With gate current thus established, charges are injected into the PLA and voltage at which forward breakover is reduced. I told you that. Now, gate current anna increase maadadangu, gate voltage across the gate cathode voltage anna increase maadadangu, gate current increase maadadai divi. ಗೇಟ್ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದಂಗು ನಮಗೆ ಬೇಕಾಗಿರೋ ಸಪ್ಲೈ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಹೋಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಸೊ ಹೈಯರ್ ದ ಗೇಟ್ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಲೋಯರ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಫಾರ್ವರ್ಡ್ ಬ್ರೇಕ್ ಓವರ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ನಮ್ಮ ಏಮ್ ಏನಪ್ಪ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಏಮ್ ಏನಂದ್ರೆ ನಾವು ಗೇಟ್ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಅನ್ನ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಮಾಡೋದ್ರಿಂದ ನಮಗೆ ಬೇಕಾಗಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ VBO ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಫಾರ್ವರ್ಡ್ ಬ್ರೇಕ್ ಓವರ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಬರುತ್ತೆ So, IG1 less than IG2 less than IG3. This is the gate current. For this gate current, is the voltage what we require to break the depletion layer, that is junction J2, is smaller voltage. From the following figure, we discuss effect of gate current on forward breakover voltage. The characteristics we already discussed. Now I want to explain this right side right? In x-axis, there is a gate current. In x-axis, there is a gate current. In y-axis, we have a forward breakover voltage. Then gate current is zero, the required voltage is VB. This is the voltage we required to bring the SCR into on state, that is VBO voltage when gate voltage is, gate current is zero. Now I increase the gate current. This is a small leakage current. OA represents small leakage current. It is not enough to bring the SCR into conduction mode. That's why again we required a VBO volts. This is showing here. If we increase further the gate current to IG1, now I increase the gate current IG1, the required forward breakover voltage, required forward breakover voltage is reduced to OX for IG1 current. IG1 current, I require voltage, forward breakover voltage is 0 to X. This is compared to VBO, it is lesser. If you further increase this gate current, if you further increase the gate current, the voltage, forward breakover voltage, what we required is OY. This range, this is the voltage we require to break the depletion region at junction J2. If you again further increase this current to I3, the required voltage is again get reduced to OZ. So it means that as you increase the gate current, the required voltage VBO is coming or reducing. This is the meaning of this graph. Next triggering method is dV by dt triggering. We are applying the forward voltage across anode and cathode, keeping the gate is open. And what we are applying the voltage across anode and cathode is VBO. With forward voltage across the anode and cathode of thyristor, the two outer junction J1 and J3 are forward biased, but inner junction J3 is reverse biased. We already discussed the positive is given to the anode or P layer, negative terminal of the battery is given to the cathode. So these two junction J1 and J3 is forward biased, J2 is reverse biased, hence it is a depletion region. This region is called as a depletion region. This reverse bias junction J2 has the characteristics of capacitor. It acts like a, when two plates, these are the two plates, J1, J2 is the two plates, in between we have a dielectric material. So it has, it acts like a capacitor, two plates, two parallel plates are there, in between we have a dielectric, it acts like a capacitor. Due to charge existing across the junction, in other words, space charge, we called as space charge, exists in the depletion region near the junction, J2 behaves like a capacitance, behaves like a capacitor. If forward voltage is suddenly applied, a charging current through the junction capacitance Cj. This Cj means junction capacitance may turn on the SCR. This is enough to turn on the SCR. Almost the entire suddenly applied forward voltage Va appears across J2. The charging current Ic is therefore given by Ic is equal to dq by dt. This is a q represents the charge, that is equal to d by dt of Cj dot VA. It is because Q is equal to CV. CJ is a junction capacitance into dVA by dt plus VA dCJ by dt. As the junction capacitance is almost constant, this is constant, differentiation of the constant is equal to 0, then what happens? dCJ by dt is 0. And current IC as IC is equal to CJ into dV by dVA by dt. Therefore, if rate of rise of forward voltage dVA by dt is high, the charging current IC would be more. This charging current plays a role of gate current and turns on the SCR. Even though gate signal is zero, we kept the gate is open. Note that even if VA is small, it is the rate of change of VA that plays a role of turning on the device. Next method of triggering is temperature triggering or thermal triggering. During forward blocking mode, most of the applied voltage appears across reverse biased junction J2. This voltage across the J2 associated with leakage current. As you know, already we discussed, there is a leakage current. Would rise the temperature of the junction. What it will do? This, due to this leakage current, junction temperature increases. Which junction? J2 junction. With increasing temperature, width of the depletion layer decreases. Due to the leakage current, the temperature across the junction J2 increases. As the temperature increases, the width of the depletion layer decreases. This further leads to more leakage current and therefore more junction temperature. What happens? Junction temperature increases. With the cumulative process, at some high temperature within the safe limit, depletion layer of reverse bias junction vanishes and device gate turns off. Next method is light triggering. For light triggering SCRs, a small window made in the inner P layer, as shown in figure. Here is the window you can see. When this small window, or we called recess, is irradiated, free charge carrier, pairs of electrons and holes are generated just like when gate signal is applied between gate and cathode. The pulse of appropriate wavelength is guided by optical fiber for irradiation. If the intensity of light thrown on this recess exceeds certain value, forward bias DSCR is turned on. LASAR, light activate silicon controlled rectifier, may trigger with the light source or with the gate signal. It can be independently trigger the trigger, or it can by using the gate signal. For this, gate is biased with the voltage or current slightly less than the required to turn it on. Now, a beam of light is directed at the inner P layer junction, turns on the SCR. The light intensity required to turn on the SCR depends upon the voltage bias given to the gate. Higher the voltage or current bias, lower the light intensity required. So you can see here this figure. This is again a SCR with a small recess or open window for light irradiation. When light falls onto this, it acts like a triggering pulse to the gate circuit. This is what the light triggering.